edition of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hey, Robin, how you doing, man?
Yeah, Tim, thank you for taking my call. I wanted to let you know that I've been a subscriber for a couple of years, just different members of your team, and I really enjoy it. But really the reason I'm calling is to express my sincerest gratitude for you providing that information yesterday on the small business grant. I'm a small business owner and primary breadwinner for my family, and if I can get that money, it's going to really mean a lot to my family. So
that's awesome.
Thank you for taking the time to do that.
No, well, listen, man, we appreciate you growling a problem with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't take anything personally. Ignore the opinions of others. This is a trippy card, man. I tell you. Whatever people do, feel, think, or say, don't take it personally. Others are going to have their own opinions according to their belief system, so whatever they think about you is not about you, but it's about them. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 564, NASDAQ's off 312, S&P's down 91, gold contract down $11, trading at $18.39 an ounce. We get silver off 30 cents, $25.23 an ounce, light sweet crude flat. $52.60 a barrel, notes and bonds. You get the 10-year note up 3 ticks, 137.15. The 30-year up 11 at 170.07 in King Dollar. King Dollar's up 477 ticks, trading out at 90.647. The euro is out here at a price point of 121. The yen is at 104. And the British pound is at 136 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, bottom line is you've been selling off all day long. You had the Fed out here. In fact, Powell's still speaking, I believe. Bottom line, status quo out here. That being said, you get the sell-off that's no doubt fast and furious. What's going to get intriguing here is to see if they if the market itself does reject lower price. You have two different areas here that we're going into. Now, this market is barreling down with volume, folks, okay? And when you do come off highs with volume, bottom line, you get a larger correction. That being said, you're coming down into the area from the 15th of January, and that's where we did come down with volume. We did 107 million shares there. You did the bounce, and the bounce was anemic. We're coming down into that area. So the number that you want to keep an eye on coming into that close is going to be that 373.70 area. And we hit 373.63 thus far today. You did reject it, but guess what? You know, you get 50 minutes here. 50 minutes is a long time in a day like today. We got to look at the NDX 100, the 3Qs. Same type of setup inside the 3Qs. The 3Qs are coming back to the breakout area, and the differential here is that the 3Qs are coming back to the breakout area with volume, and it's higher volume than we had on the breakout. The breakout, top side there was 30 million shares. You made a high out here with the 39 million shares. Well, you already did 36. So that's bottom line. That is saying that you're going to get more volume down there. Now, we haven't broken the uptrend yet, not even close either. Gold contract right now trading down $11. That is out at $18.39.60. If we go take a look at the gold contract out here, you're going to see you're pulling back into strength. You only got 183,000 contracts traded. You've already rejected 18.28. We are coming into. Yeah, you're coming into 274,000 contracts as well as 332. So you can see you need a lot more contract volume. in order to basically get a breakdown going there. The 30-year bond, that is getting closer to getting back inside its higher range. That higher range is the 171 area right now. You're about a point away from it. You know, you get 364,000 contracts today. That's good contract volume inside of that. And then good old King Dollar. We go take a look at King Dollar. And King Dollar's got quite a bounce going. That being said, what King Dollar hasn't done, which is just actually amazing. So when King Dollar went up about 10 days ago, it reached the price point of this 96,951. Well, King Dollar got up to 90.880 and basically couldn't even hit that number. Now, that normally is like, okay, you can't even handle that. That's saying you're going to go right back downtown. So there's a lot of movement out here, and you can expect we're going to see a lot more movement in the next few days. Apple's going to be coming out with, well, here, let's go to Microsoft first. MSFT, Microsoft came out with numbers. The numbers were huge this morning. Microsoft traded down, check this out, traded down to 230, traded up to 240, and now Microsoft is flat. Microsoft right now, flat market, you know, bottom line. That being said, though, what you did do is that you took out your swing, your volume on the takeout. Let's pull this back. On the daily, you get volume on the takeout. On the weekly, we're going to need 206 million. You're going to end up getting 206 million. Today's Wednesday. Well, we'll see what the end of the week. But it looks to me like you are going to get a break topside with Microsoft. Apple. Apple's going to be coming out after the close. Now, Apple, I believe, comes out even after the futures close. They normally come out at about 4:30. And Apple right now is trading down $1.60. They are going to be looking for, I believe, $120 million to the top line. So that's going to be a big number that they're looking for. It's going to be a tough day for Apple coming out with numbers when you get a rough day in the marketplace. Now, they're looking at $103 billion to the top line. They're looking for $1.42 to the bottom line. Tesla. Tesla's also coming out after the close out here. Tesla right now is trading down $16. That's trading $8.66. Revenue-wise, what Tesla's going to be looking for, Tesla's going to be looking for $10.4 billion, and they're going to be looking to make a buck. Facebook, I believe, also, is that coming out? Let's see. 27th, yep. Okay, so Facebook is trading down $10 right now. You're at $2.71. They are going to be looking for $26.4 billion to the top line and $3.22 to the bottom line. Some of the higher volume equities out here, we know that GameStop and AMC, they've been running those stocks all day long. You get AMC as the top mover out here today, volume-wise, up $13, trading $18.35. You get Pelletier up another $4, $39. Sorrento, that's starting to move again. That's up 360 at $14. GameStop is the number. GameStop's up $190, trading 339. Plug Power is down 7. You get AMD down 5.5. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 520. Get the NASDAQ off 330. S&Ps are off 30. And if we take a look at the aspect of what Powell is talking about out there, folks. This is live. Okay, so Powell's talking about the aspect that, and the Fed. The Fed continues to worry about long-term scarring effects of the pandemic on small businesses and unemployed workers. We've had a big concern about both of these. We haven't seen as much as we feared, and that's a good thing, but the jury is still out. I definitely agree with that. I mean, the amount of bread that has gone into the economy, okay, is helping people that are in tough shape, but, you know, bottom line, you know, you get the winter going on, and I just, you know, in Florida, it is different because we're outside so much, and, you know, these smaller places can basically get at least half their business when, you know, they're doing business outside. And what they did in many of these cities down here is that you took the parking spots up, you put big barriers up, okay, so at least they can try to get some business. But up north in the Midwest, it's cold. The cold was in there, and there's no doubt about it. He's talking about high housing prices, a passing phenomenon as people who are spending most of their time at home right now opt for a new or second home. So we'll see where that shakes out. And, you know, bottom line is that market-wise out here, you know, after, when these numbers come out this afternoon, it's going to be pretty intriguing to see just what this market does and what the market does in a follow-through. That's going to be the kicker out here, too. Let's go to the small caps and take a look at the small caps, the IWM. So if we take a look at the IWM, what you're going to see, the IWM gap lower. You know, you made a high out here with 33 million shares. You're coming down with 35. You'll probably do a little bit more, but, you know, there's... Right now, you're going to need a lot more juice in order to break this market down. Let me see this for a second. So if we go to the trend, you take a look at the trend. That's it. Oh, that's a 2-2. Ooh, that's a good one. That means that we get some selling here, man. That's pretty intense. Yeah, that's intense. That, there's no doubt about that. That is really intense. The tick, let's see how fast they... We're trying to get out. Yeah, that's good too. Okay, so you get some big nervousness out here. Minus 1765. I got to make sure that wasn't on the open, though. 1610. Yeah, the first. Okay, so you don't use the tick, folks, okay, on the open. What we did have a minus 1616 about 40 minutes ago. And that is also saying that folks are getting a little, you know, nervous, no doubt about it. There's a couple questions in the den, not questions as much as that, is the party over? Well, I don't think the party's over just yet. I want to see how this you do a counter-trend bounce against this. I mean, I suspect we are going to do a counter-trend bounce against it. If the counter-trend bounce has a good contraction of volume, then it'd be like, okay, we are going south. What does happen on a fundamental basis, or let's say on a basis that you have every, not just trader, not just investor, every folks that has any inclination to be on social media talking about GameStop, that no doubt is a heads up. But as I said this morning when Tommy and I were on the air, when I've seen this before, it normally just doesn't go on a couple weeks, you know. It normally goes on quite some time, and I think we very well could be at the beginning of it. We'll see. You can see that if we go over to AMC, AMC was a perfect candidate for running shots in a big way, because the AMC had a yesterday it was 13.5%. Now they're saying it's 12.6. But you can see what $5 to $14 in a heartbeat. No doubt about that. You take a look at they just try to run American Airlines. So AAL, let's take a look at this. And American, that closed last night at where are we at? Approximately $15. And you're at $16.69, and you get the juice into it. There's a lot of volume in that, man. And there's no reason that they can't run that all the way up to this 1863 area. That's how that shakes out. Let's go, let's see. GNUS. Okay, so... Gee. This is Genius, I think. Yeah, Genius Brands International. Okay, so this is children's clothing, DVDs. The lows are 5 cents. The highs 11.73. This is up 82 cents. And... I see. Okay, so this is a cycle stock also. This thing went up to $11.73 the week of June 5th. End up closing out the week of $5.90, and now it's starting again. So the real question is that I believe that they got a spread on. You know, can it go to 6.25? Yeah, it can. There's no doubt about that. One second, let me see. You get 11% short position. Yeah, there's no reason you can't. Let's take a look at RUBY. The hard thing here when you're running those stocks is that this one here, this just went to a high volume high. Now this, I just brought up Ruby. RUBY is the symbol, folks, okay? Biotech company, Cambridge, Mass, 223 employees. If you're into something like this, man, I would just take your money and run as fast as you could. There's no doubt. It just tested that high, and it looks like it's going to hold the high. But when you get such a contraction of volume, which we have there, yeah. Tomorrow morning we're going to find out what other stocks... these basically chat rooms are going to run. So picture this. If you rewind the whole story, you didn't have as much, I would say, information in 1999 as you can get right now. And, you know, the aspect of short positions that are anywhere over 10%, you know, I can see that they're going to try to run every one of them. There's everything to win and zero to lose. In fact, I got to tell you this story, folks. This is a great story. So this morning when Tommy and I were on the air, I didn't realize that you can, on Robinhood, you can buy fractional shares. Well, one of our producers bought a fractional share at $4 and I believe sold it at about 5.25. So you can imagine the aspect of millions buying fractional shares, never mind shares. And now, this is of GameStop, by the way, okay? Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 647. You get the NASDAQ off 391. S&Ps are off 107. And on that break, you just did another downdraft here. Let me just go look at this. We got to 37.34. Yeah. Inside of the S&P. And, you know, this morning what you did have, and it's, you know, you had a lot of outages inside the broker-dealer community. I believe that I got something from TD Ameritrade that you actually can't even trade. I think this is intraday, that you can't even trade GME anymore, as well as AMC. I didn't read the whole thing, but I believe that that was the heads up. And so that's going to get really intriguing in the aspect of if the broker-dealer community starts shutting down what you can and cannot buy and or sell. There's going to be major dislocation for a few firms, folks, with this GameStop deal. There's just no doubt about it. I mean, it's you can't go from a price point of, let's see. So in 3 days, we went from $43 to $380. That's 3 days. In 9 days, we went from $20 to $380. You know, you get major dislocations here. The thing that's so intriguing is the aspect of, you know, if we go to GameStop, what you're going to see, and I brought this up this morning, is that Fidelity is the largest owner of GameStop. I just can't picture that they, why wouldn't you sell everything, right? You never thought, I mean, they own 9.7 million shares, 14% of the company. You know, BlackRock's in there at 13%. I'm not quite sure where the BlackRock, though, would be all different funds, you know, smaller funds, because they own all the ETFs, of course, okay? You know, but you talk about a windfall, right? And there's plenty of liquidity to sell into it. I mean, they only own 9 million shares. It's trading 85 million shares. And if that's the case, whatever funds, actually, we can actually see. So Strategic Advisors, Fidelity Investment, three different funds they got it in. The biggest fund, though, is it just says Fidelity Management. It's a monster number, though. There's no two ways about that. You multiply that times, multiply 300 and, let's say, multiply $320 by 9.7 million. You are talking some numbers here. Okay, let's get over and take a look at the metals. So you have the dollar doing a big bounce out here. The contract itself has pulled back with dramatically lighter volume. So the contract itself, to me, is saying that, hey, guess what? The bottom line, it wants higher price. Now let's go look at the equities, though. If we go take a look at GDX, GDX is down 19 million shares, and that's going after the swing low. The swing low in GDX is 33.25. We hit 33.66. Now, that's half the volume. So the bottom line is going to need more than that to break it down. That being said, however, is that if you close at the low of the day, which we are right now, it will go after that. So you got to wait another day. I wouldn't be in there basically going after that right now, meaning going after the metals right now. An Eco Eagle, that's down 298. Now that's coming into a swing point with volume. That being said, it is not, it's coming into a breakout area with tremendously lighter volume, okay? Vista Gold looks fine. Some of these, there's a question about Vista Gold. Vista Gold's, there's no sellers down at these areas. Last time we got down there, you had 2.1 million shares, and right now you're at 582. Let's go to Bill in Atlanta. Hey, Bill, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. Say, I was just looking at, I noticed on your list, number 18 on that GameStop list was SCION Asset Management. I don't know if that's Scion or Skion or whatever that is, but the guy who runs that is Michael Burry, the guy that was depicted in The Big Short. GameStop was one of his very biggest positions for a long time. He bought tons of shares at $5, and I just noticed on your list that he has dumped $1.5 million or something.
Okay, so it's the SIG holding, right?
No, it's SCION, number 19.
Oh, 19, okay. Oh, yeah, I see. Now, that was, what? I got to get.
19.
It's not you. I got something in the way here. Yeah, there it is. I got it out of the way. Okay. Yeah, so he's probably sad that he did that now. He dumped those, though, September, the filing of September 30th. See the date beside it there?
He's a fascinating guy, and I don't know, about a week ago, I just stumbled on a look at his portfolio where GameStop was like his number one position or something.
What a trip, man.
And he says, of course, this is crazy. He says, this is just crazy.
Yeah, listen.
But he made a fortune.
The amazing part, Tommy and I were talking a little bit earlier, and the amazing part is that it's staying up at these levels, you know? I mean, that's the thing that absolutely is amazing, you know? You know, it's like, okay, so is there that much buying? Well, this morning, yeah, it was doing, I mean, let's see, it's...
Yeah, somebody's going to be hung out, and we won't find out till later.
Exactly. Right. There's no doubt. And I think the first one, of course, we already found out that was that Melvin fund. But I believe what you're going to see out here is you'll actually get some broker dealers that are hurt. And that's going to be intriguing to see what they have to say. Meaning, so when you have picture something, folks. When you have markets or you have platforms that people can't get on to buy and sell, which happened this morning on just about every platform out there, well, those positions are hanging out there. And most times, no, almost every time, your broker-dealer yourself is going to sell you out, okay, when those things are bad. Well, if the platform itself is not working, okay, even the broker deal is going to have a hard time dealing with that. And what will end up happening is that will be a material aspect for that company, if in fact that does happen, you know?
Well, so. this kind of activity is threatening the game. It's threatening the viability, the credibility of the trading game itself. And so they will meet and find ways to address it because they can't have that. They just flat can't have that.
Oh, this is no doubt. Yeah, because there's going to be pros and cons on what you just said, and I agree with you. I'm just saying that aspect of, you know, I heard a person say this morning, well, hey, inside these chat rooms, they're saying they're going after, you know, the short positions. Well, I mean, what's the difference on, you know, five broker dealers with analysis saying, hey, the stock's going to 5,000? You know, it's like, hey, you know?
Hey, have a good one.
Have a great one, man. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Directions Daily S&P Biotech 3x Bull and Bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien. Welcome back, folks. Dow. Dow is down 700 points right now. You get the S&Ps off 111, and NASDAQ is down 421, the NDX. You get some, well, the composite's down that 400. NDX is down 422. You're talking about some big numbers. That composite looks like it's going to hit that 3% level. Right now, you're down at 2.9. So if we get over and we take a look at the composite, oh, look at this gap. Oh, my God. Yeah, so they're going right to the breakout. You know, that's when it gapped up last week. Bottom line, it's finishing that gap up. And it looks like no doubt that you're going to finish at the lows of the day. So you finish at the lows of the day. We're only on Wednesday, right? Yeah, Wednesday, man. I mean, you can get some selling in here. There's no doubt. We take a look at the SPY, and the SPY is going to break this with volume. Well, it's going to be close. You're at 86 million right now. So, see, what happened here is this. We went down. You get two different areas that you got to keep your eye on. Let's see. Three. We hit the 372.01. 371 is kind of where support's going to actually come in here. And you get monster volume. I mean, I think that was, it had to be option expiration plus a reshuffling of the indices, I believe. But the bottom line, it doesn't matter. That's lined up at 136 million. We're going into 110. Really, it depends on how much they throw in at the close out here. That's how this thing is shaken out. So we'll see what they throw in at the close. But all you need is you need another down day like this in order to basically really get that market going. We could take a look at the Qs. The Qs look to me like they're going to bounce. The Qs just don't have enough juice in them. Qs came right back to the breakout area. Now, granted, you're back with monster volume. That being said, bottom line, it looks to me that the Qs can still do a bounce. So that's going to be intriguing this afternoon after the close as to what Apple can Apple pull a trick out of its bag and basically save the NDX for a few more days. What you do have out here today, and this is what you have to pay attention to, AMD, that's down big. You got the chips. You know, we talk about this a lot. The chips, money, bringing markets higher, bringing markets lower. And what you have out here today is that it's the chips that are doing some destruction inside of this marketplace. You got microchip technologies down 8.5%. You get Xilinx down 7.7%, AMD's down 7%, and Lam Research is down 7%. All big numbers. And when they start going, no matter which way they go, they can certainly get some nice corrections going. If we take a look at Lam Research, at 513, this can get down to 488 in a heartbeat. AMD, excuse me. So AMD is breaking a consolidation, going into a breakout area. Breakout area at 84 million, you're going into it with 67. We'll see how it shakes out. XAU, we'll go back to the metals for a sec here. XAUHUI, that they're also coming right into the lows that were established out here on the, I believe it was the day before Christmas, I mean the day before New Year's, not New Year's, Thanksgiving or after it, the 24th. That low there was 129, and the XAU right now you're at 131. Gold Bugs Index, same type of setup inside the Gold Bugs Index. Gold Bugs Index now is down 13. That low is we're 273 right now, and that low out there that it's going after, oh, it might have already broke it actually. Yeah, it did. This will be interesting in the Gold Bugs Index because that low that we're talking about is 274.22, and right now you're at 273. Let's go take a look at Barrick Gold. Yeah, Barrick's breaking down. Barrick's breaking. Oh, this is not good. So Barrick, this is pretty intense, actually. Barrick will be an ABC structure down. This is intense. 27, 22, approximately $5. Well, that gets you into the $19 area. Let me see what's there at 19. Oh, yeah, this can get to 19 pretty easy. Yeah, we went topside and broke out of this little deal about 5 months ago at that $19 area. Yeah, and one of our tigers is saying, who would want gold when they can have Bitcoin? There's no doubt. The thing that's pretty wild about the gold market, I'm surprised that the Reddit traders haven't found a few of the gold stocks yet. The reason being is that you do have a couple very large positions, short positions inside of that market that wouldn't take much to really move. And, you know, we'll see where it goes going forward. But I suspect any position that has a small number attached to it with a short position is going to be game here. And this is not going to be over in like a couple weeks. You know, might settle down a little, but then guess what? The bottom line is that you'll see that baby go higher once again. And a couple of the tigers saying, well, there's not many that have a low float, and that's a fact. That's a fact, and that's a big deal of running the equities when you definitely do have a low float. Let's go take a look at U.S. Steel out here. That baby rejected lower price out here today as it come back to its breakout area. We take a look at Mosaic. That also rejected lower price. Yeah, these commodities are going to get going again. See, this is going to be all about the U.S. dollar. You know, that's what this is going to be about, man. It's going to be about the good old U.S. dollar. Can the dollar hold? And I just got a heads up inside the gold market as we're talking, and we'll see. Someone just came in and bought a few ounces here, a few hundred or a thousand ounces. We just went from, 1837 to 1842. The dollar's the number here, man. This is what it comes down to. There's no doubt. And, you know, it doesn't look to me like this dollar's going to hold once again. And rates, bottom line, rates are still going lower for longer, you know. Market-wise, yeah, we're in bubblicious territory. There's no two ways about that. And, you know, after the close out here today, we're going to find out quite a bit. Particularly, you know, Microsoft came out with blockbuster numbers, and guess what? Had a 10-point spread, but when all said and done, kind of a flat market. We'll see where Apple, as well as Tesla, shakes out after the close. We'll be right back.
back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and to help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials down 600, NASDAQ off 339, S&P's off 96. Now, Tesla is going to be the one that comes out right after the close, folks. Tesla right now is trading down $14. You're at $8.68. And let's just take a look at, this still has, this looks to me like it's going to be higher. Yeah. I mean, you had a little pop up here Monday. You get volume behind it. Didn't back off. There's no reason that this can't pop once again. They are going to be looking for, I believe it was $10 billion to the top line. $10.4 billion to the top line. They're going to be looking for $1.03 to the bottom line. You know, so volume-wise out here inside of the indices, we're going to get, this is going to be big volume. So you get monster volume coming off the highs. We're already at $1.3 billion inside the NYSE. That means it's going to do a $1.8 billion. And inside, look at this. Oh, yeah, this is, you know what? I guess we're closer to the highs than... We already have 10 billion shares done, folks, on the NASDAQ composite. I don't think I've ever seen 10 billion shares before the close. That's going to bang out 12, 13 billion more than likely. So evidently that no one is working. Everyone is buying and selling. And that is saying that we're closer to basically a good size correction. Now, that being said, my take is that you will still do this counter trend bounce trying to get up into at least the lows of the high. And where I'm going with that is that the earnings that are coming out plus the window dressing. And I think once window dressing is over, I think it's going to be click, click, click. And then, you know, the bottom line is that you'll get a trend downtown. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night. Have a safe night. Come back and visit us tomorrow. Tommy kicks us off, 8:30 in the morning. Great show. Please tell your friends to go to YouTube, search TFNN, and subscribe. Have a great one, folks.